Have you ever wondered what pollen looks like super close up? Well, today we're going to be taking a really close look at some pollen inside the flower using some really interesting super macro techniques, including some lenses and some interesting lighting. Stick around and I'll get started in just a sec. Hi guys, I'm Ben from Adaptalux and welcome back to another flower photography tutorial where today we're doing something a little bit different to the flower photography that you might have seen on our channel already. I'm not looking to get a photo of this full flower, as nice as it is. I think I'm more interested in capturing some very, very close and detailed shots of the pollen in the middle of the flower. This flower in particular has a lot of pollen around the stamen. Now, to the naked eye, it just looks like clumps of dust, but I'm pretty sure that if we can get close enough, we can start to see the individual pieces of pollen all clumped together here, and I think that's going to look really, really interesting. However, it's not quite as easy as maybe some standard flower photography. We're going to need some very specific pieces of equipment, including some very special lenses and some very special lighting. Let's first of all talk about the lenses that I'm going to be using to get the required magnification for seeing these individual pieces of pollen up close. First up, I've got the 25mm f2.8 2.5 to 5 times macro lens from Laowa. This is a really nice lens. I've been using it for a while and it does get you a lot of magnification, but it's still probably not going to be close enough to get the kind of detail that I'm looking for today. And that's where Laowa has come through and sent me the Aurogon set of lenses. This is a lens set that ranges from 10 times magnification to 50 times magnification. That's absolutely huge. It's very hard to picture or even describe how close 50 times magnification is. It really is super micro photography, so think microscope level. I don't think we'd be getting up to the 50 times magnification today, but I certainly want to try out at least the 10 times magnification on my flower to see if we can't get some really nice photo stacks of this pollen all clumped together in the middle of the flower and see some of the detail on that pollen. So those are the two lenses that I'm using today, and I will explain a little bit more about how we're capturing those using these lenses as we go along. Another pretty crucial piece of equipment is my tripod here and this macro focusing rail that you can see that my camera is sat on. These are going to help to both keep my camera pretty steady, but also I'm going to need that forward to back movement of the focusing rail in order to capture some shots. The depth of field from this lens in particular is very, very narrow, so it's going to be very hard to see anything while we're taking our photographs, and we need a photo stack, a focus stack, to actually be able to see that detail realized in the final shots. So a manual focus stacking rail is good. If you've got an automated one, then even better, because we are going to be trying to reduce as much vibration as possible when using this lens in particular. The more magnification you have, the more the vibration of your surroundings is going to be affecting your images. So I'm going to start off shooting with our 2.5 to 5 times macro lens, and then we can move on to the 10 times. At magnifications like we're aiming for today, it's very difficult to compose your shot and get precision in the placement of your subject. And that's where another piece of critical equipment comes in, the macro subject holder. So this little contraption has flexible arms with crocodile clips on the end of each arm, and that allows us to clip in our subject and move it around to be exactly where we need it to be in front of the lens. This is often much, much easier than moving the camera, moving your tripod and trying to position your camera. Instead, you can place your camera where you find it comfortable and then position your subject in front of the lens where it needs to be. Now, depending on your shooting method, it depends on whether you are more comfortable moving the camera or the subject, but I would say most of the time, especially at magnifications like this, it's going to be easier to be simply changing the position of your subject rather than resetting up your camera. Especially because we're going for minimal vibrations, something like this to be able to hold your subject steady as you're shooting is really handy. We have these on our website. I will link to them up in the top right hand corner. So if you're looking for something to hold all of your subjects in place, be them flowers or anything else, this is a really handy piece of kit. I'm going to slide this in front of my lens now and see if we can't get an initial shot of the center of the flower. So here we are at 5x magnification. I'm only at f/2.8 though, so we're getting a very, very shallow depth of field, and we've got some pretty awful settings here. I'm shooting at ISO 12,800 just to get a shot of this in the ambient light that's here in my room, despite there being video lights on as well. So what I need to do here is add some extra light into this shot so we can get better settings and a better look at that initial shot of the pollen. You can see there that we can just see the beginnings of some individual balls of pollen, but when I add some lighting in, it's going to look even better. So as you can see, we've introduced a little bit more light, and that has made a huge difference to our image. You can now see that we're much better exposed. I've actually been able to reduce my ISO from 12,000 something down to 640 while making the image look much, much nicer. That's because of these two diffused white lights that are pointing right at the stamen there. Because we have some nice flexible lights designed for macro photography, we can actually get these lights really, really close to the subject and in between this very, very small working distance between the front of the lens and our subject without disturbing anything too much. So I've stacked those shots in helicon focus, and as you can see, we're already getting a huge amount of magnification and detail. You can see all of those individual pieces of pollen and some of the detail on the individual pieces, which I wasn't expecting from this magnification, but we are going to get even closer as well. We're going to get almost twice as close with the 10x macro lens. First though, I did want to talk about our lighting a little bit more because it wasn't really very easy to see in that last shot. It was all exposed for the flower, but you can see nice and clearly here we are using the Adaptalux Studio. This is the control pod at the top here. This has 5 ports for 5 different lights. It's got power and control for those lights, and we've got it sat here on a little mini tripod so that I can place it wherever it needs to be. And it's that placement that's really important for a shot like this. Just like our macro subject holder is important for placing the subject exactly where it needs to be in front of the lens, we also need precision in our lighting. So the lighting arms that plug into the control pod are also really flexible, and they just click into place and we have some instant lighting that we're able to place wherever we need it to be, pointing at the parts of our subject that need the most light. We also have diffusion and multiple lights, so we can plug in several of these at once and place lights coming from multiple directions, and that's also really important for controlling our shadows and balancing out the brightness. You can change the brightness of each of these individually as well using the manual controls on the top of the pod or using our free Bluetooth app as well. So there's a lot of precision and control over your lighting when you're using a light source designed specifically for macro photography, just like this one is. So I recommend having something like this, just like I recommend having something like the macro subject holder, so that you're able to get that fine precision that you need when you're working with magnifications like 5x and 10x. So as you can see, a few things have changed here, mainly that magnification. We're now on the Aurogon set of lenses at 10x magnification, but that is already enough to be giving us a really nice view of that pollen. But it comes with a few issues that we've not experienced yet. The main one being the stability. As you can see, as I move my weight around, just stepping in different places on my floor, the movement of my body is moving my shot. So you do definitely need a nice stable environment to be shooting at this kind of magnification. I'm going to push ahead and try and stay as still as possible while doing my stack, but it's definitely worth it if you've got, say, a concrete floor, or if you're on the ground floor, unlike me up in my apartment. Every time a car drives past, even, we're getting a little bit of vibration. So it's definitely worth being conscious of the vibrations and movement in your environment. The other thing that's changed is the working distance here. So the distance between the subject and the end of the lens has changed. We're much, much closer. And that means that I've had to modify my light a little bit. I've taken one of the diffusers away and moved that light in much, much closer. That's giving us a lot more light, which is nice because we need a lot more light for this lens. And it's also changing the look of the pollen a little bit to bring out some of the details on the surface. So hopefully we're going to be able to see some little spikes and interesting bits of detail on the pollen. You can't see, really very much at the moment because the depth of field with this lens at this magnification is even shallower than the 5x lens. So we're going to be doing a lot more photos in our photo stack, and they're going to be a lot more temperamental because of that movement. So it's going to be a little bit of a risky focus stack, but hopefully we can get it done. So a focus stack at 10x magnification is pretty tricky. I had a couple of failed stacks just from that movement of me moving around and the camera actually shifting its weight on the tripod can have an effect. It moves the image down ever so slightly. So it's definitely something that is doable at home with 10x magnification like this. But I think for any higher magnifications, I'm going to need a different setup with a lot more stability, and I'll probably have to go somewhere else that isn't a high up apartment with loose floorboards and a fairly rickety table. So make sure to hit the subscribe button if you want to see the rest of the magnification factors in this Aurogon set. I will be doing a full shoot with all of the magnifications in the future, probably on a different subject as well. So stick around and make sure that you're here for that video by hitting the subscribe button. If you've got any experience with this type of lens or micro photography, let me know any tips that you have down in the comments as well, because this is brand new to me. Any higher magnification than this 10x macro is going to get exponentially harder, I think. So I'm going to look out for any tips that you guys put in the comments. For now, I'm pretty happy with the detail that we've got from this 10x magnification on this pollen. You can see all of the individual little spikes on the individual pieces of pollen, which is exactly what I was looking for from this shoot. I think when it comes to flower photography, a lot of people are happy enough to just get a shot of the flower and not really think about what happens if you get closer and focus in on the details within that flower. I think it actually starts to reveal a whole new world of flower photography, in that the centers, the stamen, the pollen, it all has a whole world of detail that you can't see in a regular flower photograph. If you have the ability to get really, really close with lenses like the ones I've been using today, then you can start to explore even deeper. Now, of course, not everybody's going to want a 50x macro lens set, but I continue to be very impressed with the 2.5 to 5x macro lens from Laowa. It gives you a lot of more magnification when you want it, while still being able to get a reasonable amount just for more general shots. The Aurogon lens set, however, is very intriguing. I know I've only touched on it in today's video, but my first impressions are that it will open up a huge new world of macro and, well, micro photography, really. It's something that's going to take a bit of a learning curve. I'm just starting out on that curve, and maybe you'll want to follow with me, so do remember to hit that subscribe button for more macro photography tutorials, ideas, and inspiration coming in the future. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this tutorial, and make sure to leave me a comment down below with your thoughts on my shots today. For now, that is all I've got time for. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.